Welcome to the Smoke Learning Channel. Starting with this video, you're about to start a journey into the exploration of the painting capabilities of Autodesk Smoke. We'll first start off by looking at the types of paint tools available and their uses. We'll briefly touch on their inner workings, and finally, you can choose which tool you would like to focus on through the links on YouTube and downloads through iTunes. Smoke provides you with two types of painting tools in two different locations within the application. There is desktop paint, and there is ConnectFX paint. Starting with the desktop paint, this tool is located in the Tools tab. This paint tool allows you to work on individual sources independent of a timeline or sequence. So you can do something to a clip or make an element before editing it into the sequence. Some practical examples include artistic painting, image retouching, motion graphic design, or animatable brushstrokes. Desktop paint uses a raster-based or bitmap-based painting engine. It is important to know this when deciding what paint tool to use for a specific job. In the case of desktop paint, when you paint a stroke, it is already committed on the image and new media is produced instantly with no rendering required. Other raster-based painting tools such as Photoshop and Corel Paint function in a similar way. The other paint tool in Smoke is the ConnectFX paint. This paint tool is already incorporated into the sequence using the ConnectFX node-based environment. This allows paint to have a live interaction with the sources going in and out of the node. So you could tweak something before the ConnectFX paint node and the results will ripple through the paint tools. Some examples include artistic painting, retouching images, retouching mats and alphas, and creating elements for motion graphic design. ConnectFX paint uses a vector-based painting engine. Similar to desktop paint, knowing what the paint tool is doing helps when deciding what paint tool to use for a specific job. In the case of ConnectFX paint, the strokes are always redrawing themselves every frame. The strokes are live and non-destructive, making it very useful within this flexible environment. This will become very clear as you go through the various videos. There is quite a lot of overlap between the paint tools, so some of the videos might seem repetitive, but the workflows will differ depending on the option you choose. You can now select which paint tool you would like to learn through the YouTube links and the iTunes downloads. More videos will be added to the playlist as they become available. Thank you for watching, and please subscribe to the Smoke Learning Channel for future videos.